Let go and let of the Lord your God would speak and say unto thee this day, that I have many things for thou to view. Yea, this shall be a viewing day, saith the Spirit of the Lord. I will parade before you great mysteries and great truths. I will parade before you faith as you've never seen it. Dimensions of my glory you've never fathomed. Yea, this day I will awaken in your heart a new vision, saith the Spirit of the Lord, and a new desire for deeper things of me, saith God. And yea, no man shall put it there, but I shall put it there by my Spirit, says the Lord. And I shall burn upon thy heart with a great burning and with a great fire this day, saith the Lord. And yea, I shall ignite thy soul, and yea, I shall illuminate thy heart, and yea, ye shall leave this place shining as a lamp and a bright light, for I give unto thee this day the pleasures of my kingdom, withholding nothing from thee, my people. I speak unto thee in secrets, and in deep voices do I utter my great truths, saith the Lord. And yea, thy heart shall see and shall know that this is the place that I have called thee unto. This is the place that I have ordained for thy feet, saith the Lord. Not that you should stand with a great crowd and view from afar off, but that you shall separate yourself from that large and mighty group and come into this holy and sanctified people and know me in this realm and in this dimension, saith the Spirit of the Lord. So fear nothing, and let all worry leave thee this day. For yea, worry has robbed thee of many things that I have ordained for thee, because thou hast sat in the wrong seat when I have called thee up hither. Yea, sit no more in this place, saith the Spirit of the living God, but come on up, sons and daughters, into me this hour, and sit with me in this holy and hallowed place of glory, and I shall cause thee to feel the ease of my Spirit, and you shall not work, labor, toil, nor sweat, but you shall only be carried away and lifted up by the rhythms of my glory and by my Spirit. And yea, the song shall come in abundance and in many lines and in many verses, saith the Lord. And in these days that are at hand, I say unto thee, watch and look for it. For I will write unto thee a whole new way of singing and a whole new songbook of songs. Yea, every time thou shalt get in the Spirit, it shall be easy to tap into my glory and utter the songs of the heavens, saith God. New songs, saith the Holy Ghost. New songs. A new song. Sometimes the Lord would say, every week I'll give you a new song, and you shall sing them. And the more you sing them, the more of my glory will fill the temple. The more my presence will fill the house. The more my cloud will come upon thee. And yea, saith the Lord, they'll come from afar to watch thee haze away in my glory. Yea, they'll see you only for a second, and only for a moment, saith the Lord. And then my glory shall swallow thee whole. Edomahasan, they will have to look only at the cloud of my presence, saith the Spirit of the Lord. Yea, if you'll let me and if you'll stay out of my way, I'm going to show thee great and mighty things, saith the Lord. But yea, I say unto thee, do not try to manipulate these things, and do not try to make them happen. Only lean back in me. Only stay in me and in my presence, and if you'll do this, saith God, I'll show you some things. I'll show thee my glory so thick and so strong and so mighty that even your visibility in the natural will become blurred, and you will not be able to see the surrounding things of this room even, but you shall only behold the effects of my power and my Spirit in manifestation and in it work. So I call thee to arms this morning. O army of the Lord, I call thee to arms. This is a day to go forth. This is not a day to sit. This is a day to arise. Arise, my beloved, and come away with me. For yea, I'm taking thee into a place that is reserved for thee, one that is prepared for thee, and one where you shall not feel much of a transition, for you'll feel like you're at home when you come into this place, saith the Lord. Yea, you'll drop your burdens, you'll drop your cares, you'll drop your sorrows, you'll dry your tears, you'll stop crying. Oh, hallelujah, your whining will cease, your complaining will stop, your murmuring will be healed, for I shall bring thee into full joy and full peace, saith the Lord God Almighty. So know this day that I've single-handedly selected you as my own representative. You are ambassadors of this glory, and you are called to represent your heavenly country, saith the Spirit of the Lord. Not to represent the earthly, but to represent the heavenly, saith the Lord. So I no longer will tolerate you remaining in the earthly. Yea, I say unto thee, not as children, but as full-grown sons, go no more into that realm, saith the Lord, and touch the things that are tainted with death, but come up into this realm, saith the Lord, and yea, no death shall touch thee. Hallelujah. It'll not work in thee. It'll not speak through thy mouth. It'll not think through thy mouth. So these are days of my presenting, and I will present thee unto myself a glorious church, not having spot, wrinkle, blemish, or any such thing, saith the Spirit of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, lift your hands and love him.
Now, you can only get that image by the Spirit. Hallelujah. And it's the work of grace in your life. In other words, it's God doing by His Spirit what I could never do by my effort. You know, the beauty of it, the Spirit that He's doing it with lives inside of me. Because He's able to do exceeding and abundantly above all I could ever ask or think, according to the power which worketh in us. Hallelujah to God. So we ain't talking about some little being floating around somewhere. We're talking about the work of grace on the inside of you. Now, last week, I woke up to this. There is a river. Last Sunday, I went to Sunshine and ministered from that. Came here Sunday night, and Matt spoke directly from Ezekiel's river. So we're going to do what? We're going back to Ezekiel 47. So let's go there. Because I want you to understand something. There's always a river. There's always a flow of the life of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And listen to me. Your persuasion of it, of your faith, doesn't cause it to flow. It's already flowing, folks.
Yeah. Amen.
Hallelujah. Now I'm going to tell you, now listen to me now. I always thought now that God reacted to my faith. But I found out what my faith does is plug me into the acting of God. God's not sitting in the position waiting to see whether or not I am or I'm not. What God's doing, He's just flowing all goodness. He's just flowing all love. He's just flowing all mercy. He's a continual, uninterrupted flow of prosperity, of abundance. Hallelujah. Of healing. It's the one continual flow. Just one continual flow. And what my faith does is plug me into the flow.
Amen. Hallelujah.
It just plugs me in. Amen. Because we're going to talk about, this because in Ezekiel 1, see, he's by the river. Remember, he's in Babylon and there by the river.
That's right.
Of Shebar. The heavens open.
Right.
And he began to see the visions of God.
Amen.
Amen. But the Lord did not have the purpose of just leaving him by the river. The intended purpose was to bring him to a point where he's one with the river.
Yes, yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory.
See, the river is the life of God. It begins and ends in God. So that means really it has no beginning. And it has no end.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
It's always there.
Always. Glory.
Always there. Always. David said, "Thou wilt show me the path of life." That there's always, oh hallelujah. It's always there. Always there. The wisdom of God and the knowledge of God and the understanding of God. You know, I had to come under submissive to this the last couple of weeks. Of every day, not trying to look 2 weeks down the road and say, "Lord, you know I need this by this, and you know I need this by this time." What am I doing? I'm trying to predetermine God. I'm trying to tell God what the outcome needs to be. If I'm doing that, how in the world can I consciously go into prayer and be listening for the influence of God when I've already set a predetermined outcome? So I got convicted for it. So what did I do? Every day. I don't think about 2 weeks down the road. I don't think about 2 days down the road. I don't even think about the next day. I sit in prayer and say, "Lord, you're going to show me everything that's good for me today.
Right.
Hallelujah. You're going to lead me. You're going to show me the path of life for today."
Right. Right.
For today. So every day, you can tap into that flow of the river. Every day, you can have spiritual insight. Every day, hallelujah. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
You can move only in the direction of divine wisdom.
Yes.
Every day.
Amen.
Every day. Now, you've got to let go and let God now. You got to let go away it appears. You got to let go away it sounds.
Hallelujah.
Neither one of us are called to hold on to two dimensions. In the sense of holding on the way it looks like with one hand, and then the other hand trying to hold truth. No, if you've run to God for your life, you have every right to take both your hands and go beyond what it appears and lay hold of the truth.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
And know that because of your plugging into that, it has no choice but to appear in your life.
Hallelujah.
In your life. You got to let go of yesterday. If fear is your motivation, it's the lowest form of motivation there is. And whatever you get through fear, you'll have to try to keep it through fear. That's why salvation, so to say, doesn't stick half the time. Because religion gets you motivated come to this place of oneness with Jesus through fear of dangling you over hell.
Right, right.
And so what do you got to do? You got to have sermons once a month. That scares the hell out of folk.
Sure.
To
right.
Keep them.
Keep them.
You got to let go of that.
Thank you.
says the Lord. Let go of the dealings of the past, says the Lord.
Yes.
Pull up the stakes today, says the Lord. Listen to my voice as I carry you out through the current.
Yes.
Unto a place of waters that you can swim in.
Hallelujah.
A place of a consciousness that you can only think the thoughts of God. I'm taking you there by my spirit, says the Lord. So your effort will have no glory in this place.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen, amen.
Praise God.
Hardest thing to labor is to labor into the rest. To cease from. To cease from.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So let's walk through some of this. Glory be to God. Afterward, he brought me, this is 47, I did tell you 47 times. Afterward, he brought me again to the door of the house. Now, who's the door? Amen. Amen. He's the only way you're going to enter into it.
Hallelujah. Lord.
Woo! Now, I want you to know something. The door is not shut. It ain't cracked open. You don't have to worry about it if you can just get your foot in the door. It ain't got nothing to do with that anymore.
Right.
Revelation 4, and behold, I saw a door open. In the spirit. Hallelujah. You ain't got to worry if you fit the qualifications or if you're worthy enough to walk through the door.
Hallelujah.
He's made you worthy. He's made you partakers. Yes. Your work has nothing to do with it. Not a thing to do with it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I mean, come on. We think we're not worthy because of... Can I just get down to the meeting, right? Because we don't, you know, maybe we don't eat right like we should. So we're not worthy to be in good health. See, that's condemnation, folks.
Yes, it is.
I'm telling you, you can just walk through the door to perfect health. You can walk right through to the door.
Hallelujah.
Walk right through the door. And the spirit can influence all the other stuff. Amen. Hallelujah. Because our what we said, what we didn't say, what we did or what we didn't do, we're as condemning on what we did as much as we are on what we didn't do. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's constant. I mean, and what's it called? Looking at good and looking at evil and trying to make it, you know what I'm saying, reward and punishment, living out life, all that stuff's going to keep you out the flow. Whether you do it over yourself or any other creation. Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah to God. So he brought me to the house, to the door of the house, and behold, so this thing ain't coming by information, is it? Coming by revelation. Behold is a revelation word.
Right.
Hallelujah. That means it's a spiritual thing.
Yes, yes.
You ain't going to find it in a laboratory.
Uh-huh.
You ain't going to come across it with another pill.
No.
Come on, you ain't going to go over there and get you an MRI or an X-ray. They're going to reveal it to you.
Right.
Hallelujah. They're going to take, you're going to take one more vitamin and it happened. This thing's coming by the Spirit. This move of God's coming by the Spirit. This experience in your life is coming by the Spirit.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. You've got to behold it. You have to be a beholder in this day. Ooh, hallelujah. It's just as important as you being a hearer of the word and honoring the word. You got to behold these things.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
You ain't seen anything? Ask the Lord to open your eyes.
Amen.
That you can see. And quit arguing with what He is showing.
That's right.
I mean, Jesus steps here. Hallelujah. The fullness. I mean, Paul writes in Romans 1 that the things made. Reveal the invisible God.
That's right.
But how many knows you can't get a full picture of Him in the trees and the birds and the bees and all that stuff. But the
the expression of life. But it's many manifestations of it.
Right.
Hallelujah. On a corporate level. When you start talking about Christ, especially when you get to the epistles and all on it, when you start talking about Christ, you ain't talking about that one that walked the shores of Galilee. You're talking about that one that came up out of the ground.
Yeah.
The many members.
Right.
Some. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So behold, waters issued out from under the threshold of the house eastward. For the forefront of the house stood toward the east, and the waters came down from under the right side of the house at the south side of the altar.
Right.
Now, okay. What's the altar? It's the place of judgment. What's the altar? It's the cross. What's the altar? It's the finished work.
Yes.
Amen.
Glory. In the garden, there's a tree. Out from that tree, through the garden, flowed a river.
Yes.
And that river broke out into four directions. And it covered all.
All right.
Hallelujah. That lets me know that there's one life that flows through everything. What we're doing is we're becoming more and more aware that that life is the only life. That life that is life.
Hallelujah.
And it's out of the finished work. It's out of the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the world.
Right.
It's out of that understanding that we begin to experience the flow of that life. Kind of hard to stay healed if you think He's got to come heal you.
Right.
It's kind of hard to stay walking in blessing if you think He still needs to come bless you.
That's right.
Amen. Hallelujah. Why? Because when you fall under that, you start wondering, where did you go wrong? What did you do to stop it? The only thing was that you became unaware of it. You thought you were responsible for the flow. I got good news for you. Ruth, all that thou requires, I will do for you. Everything you need, I got it.
Hallelujah.
I got you covered.
Amen.
I got you covered. Call unto me and I will answer thee.
Yes.
And show thee great and mighty.
Yeah. Yeah,
I guess they just like mighty stuff, but it's hidden things.
Yeah.
Things
right.
That the natural mind cannot comprehend.
Right. Amen.
Hallelujah. That's why he looks at me and says, been given unto you to know
the
mysteries.
Yes.
Hallelujah. What religion can't comprehend. What Egypt can't comprehend.
Right.
What Babylon can't comprehend.
Right.
What the mind of man can't comprehend and never will be able to comprehend. It's a gift to you.
Yes.
Woo! Hallelujah. It ain't your responsibility. I'm giving it to you.
Glory.
You didn't earn it. You didn't do nothing to deserve it. I just gave you a knowledge. Hallelujah. It takes you to a place where you live out the life of the kingdom of God.
Glory.
Because this place is going to be so big, the enemy can't even touch you.
Yeah.
kingdom, the thoughts that kept you from being healed, the thoughts that's kept your business from prospering, the thoughts that kept your life from all being a reflection of Him, I'm going to put so much distance in between them.
Hallelujah. Absolutely.
He said, Zion's will be something to look upon.
Yeah.
Ooh, something worth seeing. Yeah. In this place, hallelujah, He said the stakes ain't going to be removed.
That's right.
He said you ain't going to be able to loosen the cords.
That's right.
My word. That's time to go to that place. It's time to let the Spirit take us. It's time for a change. It's time for a renovation.
Yes.
It's time for a spiritual renewal. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I mean, you can't listen. Well, let's just read. And when, then He brought me out the way of the gate northward and led me about the way with out unto the utter gate by the way that looketh eastward. Behold, there ran out waters on the right side. And when the man that had the line in his hand went forth eastward, He measured 1,000 cubits, brought me through the waters. The waters were to the ankles. Matt touched this last Sunday night. A day of the Lord, that's 1,000 years. 1,000 years is as a day.
Yes.
Revelation talks about the millennial reign.
Yes.
Don't go look at your calendar.
No.
Don't go look at your watch. Don't go to the newspaper. It's the spirit. It's the rule of the day of the Lord.
Yes, right. Yes.
So what does He do? The dominion of that day takes me out. Come on. He takes me. The man. The image. The image now. Man's what? Created in the image and the likeness of God.
Right.
The image and the likeness of God, that's what's taking you out. Into the day of the Lord. 1,000. Ain't got nothing to do with that man going out there with some measuring tape, measuring 1,000. Does it? Ain't got a thing to do with that, does it? We understand that? It's talking about the more and more I come under that influence of the day of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Of that light.
Glory.
Of that revelation. Of that truth. As not being separate from that day. But as being of that day.
Praise the Lord.
Being part of that day. An expression of a day. Woo! Hallelujah. And not some cardboard expression either. A living expression of that day.
Hallelujah.
That's what's taking me out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And it says that, and He brought me through the waters were to the ankles. You can't put no stakes there though. You can't just get your feet wet.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Hallelujah to God. Glory ain't a little dabble, do you?
Mm-mm.
No. Hallelujah. I'm pressed to say your submissive spirituality is probably more important Monday and Tuesday than it is on Sunday and Wednesday. Because it's kind of easy to be spiritual when you're around a bunch of burning coals.
Yeah.
Amen. Kind of easy to give off light. Hallelujah. But when you ain't around nobody, all you have is the presence of God.
Amen.
All you have is the influence of the kingdom on your life. Hallelujah. That's when you shine the most. Woo! Glory be to God. Hallelujah. You got to pull up the stakes.
Yes.
Oh, hallelujah. We got to go. We got to go farther and farther into this knowledge.
Oh, hallelujah, Jesus.
Amen. If what we knew was enough.
across that we've never heard.
Folks, it could be the same thing you've heard a thousand times with your natural ears, but this time you're going to hear it by the Spirit.
Amen.
We're looking for some off-the-wall thing.
Right.
Hallelujah. Just know that you're going to hear it way you've never heard it before.
Oh, yeah.
Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah. And hear it.
Hallelujah.
And when you hear it, you're going to be converted. And when you're converted, you're going to be healed.
Hallelujah.
Absolutely.
Coming here, we can preach Ezekiel's River for 4 months, and every time you come in here, you can hear something brand new.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
You can do that by not coming here and put down your stake. You can't come in here and drive your stake down on the ground and say, by golly, this is it. No. There's a new song being sung with a new melody.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You ain't heard the last of David's harp. You ain't heard the last song that the psalmist of his was playing. Oh, Asaph ain't sang his last song yet. Now I can hear it by the Spirit. He summons them all to the door of the temple, and it's time to play again.
Yeah.
It's time to play again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Need their natural ears at the house.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Woo! When you go to Walmart, leave them at the house. You're ambassadors of this thing. Hallelujah. Legal representatives of the kingdom of God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through the waters. The waters were to the knees. Again, he measured 1,000 and brought me through where, and waters were to the loins.
Right.
To the waist, but half, waist high is what? Still half dry.
Right. Yeah.
Amen.
Right.
Glory to God. Afterward, he measured 1,000, and it was a river that I could not pass over. For the waters were risen. Waters to swim in. A river that could not be passed over. And listen what he says to him. And he said to me, son of man, hast thou seen this? In other words, he says, do you understand what you're looking at?
Yeah.
Do you understand the magnitude? Not just, hallelujah, not just seeing it by the letter, not just seeing it in the book, but do you really understand? Do you comprehend this? Paul said, God of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
The Father of glory.
Right.
Hallelujah. Grant unto us the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him.
Oh, hallelujah.
That the eyes of our understanding being enlightened, that we might wonder. That we might guess. That we might think so. No. That we might know.
Hallelujah.
What is the hope or the expectation of my calling? No. His calling. His calling. His calling. Woo! Hallelujah to God. Hallelujah to God. Man. Do you understand?
Oh, hallelujah.
Do you comprehend? The length and the breadth and the depth and the height of the love of God. Ooh, hallelujah. Do you know that this thing can't be interrupted? Do you understand this thing can't be died down? Oh, this water rises. Hallelujah to God. Woo, there ain't a little trickle coming out from the throne. Oh, there ain't just a little stream, just a little, oh, hallelujah, a little creep coming out. This water is getting deeper, and it's getting deeper, and it's getting deeper, and the messenger's taking him farther out into it, and he's taking him out into it, where he takes him to that place where he's no longer him and the river. It's just him in the river. It's just one expression of the life of God.
Hallelujah.
Not about always a flow of the life of God. When you look at someone, are you looking at their behavior? But Ezekiel, do you comprehend the river? You're walking to an office, they've labeled you, not by the river, by medication or by disease or by this and that. They're chart identified.
Right.
This life of God wants to take us so far away. When they see us, they'll say, "That's you."
Yeah.
You don't look like you looked like the last time I saw you. What happened to you? I seen the river.
Yeah, hallelujah.
I comprehended the
glory. Glory.
I came one with the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh, yes, you need to come one with the message. I understand that. But don't put your stakes there. We want to experience this thing.
Yeah.
Glory. Is that not this to me? Isn't that your desire?
Hallelujah. Yes.
Isn't that your true desire?
Hallelujah. Yes.
That you experience Him in His fullness.
Glory. Yes.
What is the river? The river is a people. The river is a life of God that not only flows to His creation, but it flows in His creation.
Yes.
Let's not stop there. It flows through His creation. I mean, that's the appearance you need. The appearance not just of Him coming to you, but Him coming in you.
Yes.
Don't stop there. We need Him to come through us.
Glory.
That He may be glorified in His.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Everybody's up on stage. Huh? All right. We'll continue. I wouldn't matter.
Glory. Praise the Lord God.
Listen. I'll just stop there. Listen. Adam is given a command. Much it was not to eat, it probably was really to eat of the tree of life. What is that tree of life? It's the word of God.
Right.
It's the word of the kingdom. But not only do you eat of the tree, you drink of the river.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You drink of that life. You partake of that life. That you may become that life.
Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Everywhere we'll see. Everywhere this river goes. Death is swallowed up by the life of the river. You think your words and your thoughts don't mean anything. They're being expressed somewhere, folks.
Hallelujah.
How many times did Jesus turn around and then people hadn't said a word? He said, "I knew your thoughts."
Yeah, right. The
only way He could know them was if He could see them. That means they had to be given an expression somewhere. What they believed had to be given an expression. Amen. Hallelujah.
Glory
to God. Allow yourself to get into the current of this river. That's flowing. God bless you this morning.